Assalamu alaikum. Welcome to the Electrical Power Transmission course. Today I am going to explain main components of overhead transmission line and their importance. This topic belongs to mechanical design of overhead transmission line. In the previous lectures, we have discussed that an overhead system is universally adapted for the transmission of electrical power over long distances. Due to economical consideration. Now, the successful operation of an overhead transmission line depends to a great extent upon the mechanical design of the line. It is because an overhead line is subjected to uncertain weather conditions and other external interferences such as high-speed winds, storms, rain, etc. Hence, it requires proper mechanical factor of safety in order to ensure the continuity of the operation in the line. In general, an overhead transmission line consists of the following main components: conductors, line supports, line insulators, cross arm, peak of the transmission tower, cage of the transmission tower body, damper, and other miscellaneous components. Now I am going to discuss briefly about each components of the transmission line. The detailed discussion on each component will be fully covered in the coming lectures. First, I am going to discuss about the conductors of the overhead transmission line. The conductors in the transmission line carry electrical power from the sending end stations to the receiving end station. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the conductor in the transmission line. The most commonly used conductor material in overhead lines is aluminium and its alloys. For single circuit line, 3 conductors are used, whereas for double circuit line, 6 conductors are used. Now I am going to discuss about the line supports of the transmission line. Line supports may consist of poles, towers that provide support to conductors and keep the conductors at a suitable level above the ground. Consider the figure which shows different line supports which consist of poles and towers suitable for different voltages. They maintain the proper spacing between the conductors in order to avoid any short circuit. They also maintain the ground clearance in order to avoid short circuit between the conductors and ground. Now I am going to discuss about the line insulators of the transmission line. Line insulators are used to mechanically support the line conductors and isolate them electrically from the ground. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the line insulators used to electrically isolate the conductors from the tower. It is necessary to prevent the short circuit between the conductor and tower. It is because steel towers are also the type of conductors and aluminium conductor is also working as conductor. Therefore, if they are directly connected, a short circuit will occur and it will damage the transmission line. That's why the overhead line insulators are used to separate the line conductors from each other and from the supporting structures electrically. The most commonly used material for insulators of overhead line is porcelain. There are several types of insulator, but following 4 types of insulators are most commonly used in the transmission line. Number 1, pin type insulators as shown in the figure. Number 2, suspension type insulators as shown in the figure. Number 3, strain insulator as shown in the figure. Number 4, shackle insulator as shown in the figure. Now I am going to discuss about the cross arm of the transmission line. They provide support to the insulators. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the cross arm. This cross arm is providing mechanical support to the insulators in order to maintain proper spacing between the conductors. Now I am going to discuss about the peak of the transmission tower. It may be defined as the portion of the transmission tower above the top cross arm is known as peak of the transmission tower. Now question may arise that why this peak is used in the transmission line. The answer to this question is that generally earth shield wire is connected at the tip of this peak. Now again question may arise that what is this earth shield wire and why it is used. The answer to this query is that the overhead earth wire or ground wire is used to protect the overhead transmission line from lightning. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the earth shield wire connected at the tip of the peak of the line. This wire is connected from one transmission tower to another transmission tower above the transmission line and well grounded at regular interval. Now I am going to discuss about the cage of the transmission tower. The portion between tower body and peak is known as cage of the transmission tower. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the cage of the transmission tower. It can be noticed that this portion of the tower is very important and holds the cross arms of the transmission line. Now I am going to discuss the transmission tower body. It can be defined as the portion from the bottom cross arm up to the ground level is known as transmission tower body. Consider the figure in which arrow shows the transmission tower body. It can be noticed that this body has the range between bottom cross arm up to ground level. This portion plays a vital role in maintaining required ground clearance of the bottom conductor of the transmission line. Now I am going to discuss about the dampers in the transmission line. A damper is used to minimize the vibration in the overhead transmission line which occur due to high speed winds. These vibrations may break the conductors leading to power failure. Apart from these components, the high voltage transmission line consists of step up and step down transformers, voltage regulating devices, lightning arresters, circuit breakers, and relays to ensure the satisfactory service of the transmission line. Now I am going to ask one common sense question. Have you ever noticed that what type of insulation is used across the overhead transmission line conductors? One may reply that he has not seen any insulation wrapped across the conductor of the transmission line. However, this is not true. In overhead lines, air acts as the insulation. The necessary insulation between the conductors can be provided by adjusting the spacing between them. That's all for today's lecture. I hope you really enjoyed this lecture. Friends, I upload many videos based on various topics of power system and motivation on regular basis. Therefore, don't forget to subscribe my channel in order not to miss my latest videos. And don't forget to share my videos with your friends and class fellows so that they can also get benefit from these videos. Thank you very much.